To calculate what is horizontal shading device, we need to understand what is vertical shading angle. So for that, we need to understand what is, we need to know what is your latitude. So first thing, please note down. So first, please note down the latitude. So based on the latitude, we can calculate what is the altitude angle for summer solstice. What is altitude angle for winter solstice? Okay. So summer solstice altitude angle is equal to is 90 plus 23.5 minus your latitude. Is equal to whatever the answer comes. Let's consider x, y. So you need to write your answer, whatever is your answer. Okay, for winter solstice. For winter solstice, the same equation, it will be like 90 minus 23.5 minus latitude is equal to, let's say, y. Horizontal shading device can be in the shape of, let's say, chajja is, that is projections, yes, it can be, yeah. Or sometimes what happens, it can be in terms of, let's say, instead of chajja, I'll take a building block itself. Let's say ground floor is something like this, yes, which is having a window. I can take my first floor slab itself. So this itself becomes like a horizontal projection, or it will become like a, so if I am taking my building block like this, so then what happens, I can cut down whatever, I can allow only the winter sun after some time, but I am cutting down most of the sun. So this I can employ, let's say, towards south direction. Okay. So some architects, what they do is, they design the building facade in such a way that it itself becomes shading this thing. So they take the building something like this. Let's say this is ground floor. It can be taken only on one side. So every floor I'm going to project somewhere a little more. Yes. So what happens here, this facade, let's say if it is south direction, or if it is, let's say, some other direction which is getting lot of sunlight, or which has to be shaded. Let's say if sun is, if I want to shade this, so these without any this thing, so I get this complete portion is always shaded. So this portion gets shaded. Okay. So this facade is also shaded. Okay. So these many times they do this kind of arrangement, or this is how, this is a building mass. Okay, so this is, we call it as mass. This is what I tried to convey in my previous class. So we can use the mass itself to shade a particular part of the building or the complete building itself. Okay. So we also use the technique which is called as mutual shading. Yes. So mutual shading is nothing but, well, let's say if there is one building block, let's say there is one building block. Okay. So this building block is again for the mutually shading other blocks. Yes. So because of, let's say, sun, if the sunlight is in this direction, so it is shading these other blocks. Yes. This whole portion will get shaded. Whatever the buildings that are coming in this portion will also get shaded. So let's say if I am building my next building here, yes, or if it is the same building which is having, which can have these kind of arrangement where, let's say if this is one building. So there is another building which has to be shaded. So I can create a building block like this. Or it can be the same building which is again further is shaded. So this portion will get shaded. Okay. So this whole portion, all the roof and these things will get shaded because if sunlight is coming from, let's say, this direction. Okay. So this can also be calculated if we know the proper altitude angle. Okay. Now we always see that altitude angle is based on, let's say if your building block is like this, so sun rises in east, okay, sun rises and it goes to the horizon, zenith, and it sets.
Okay.
So these are various angles that are created because of the sun.
Okay.
So this is nothing but, again, this you can call it as altitude angle.
Okay.
So I hope everybody has got altitude angle.
Okay.
So now altitude angle, it's very easy to design horizontal shading device. Yes. So horizontal shading device, let's start with I think a single line. So these are two parallel lines. Yes, these are two parallel lines. So this angle theta. Yes. Yes. This angle theta. Is it equal to this angle? So whatever angle I am getting, this is nothing but it is a shading angle. So that is why what happens, this triangle, yes, for this triangle we consider this angle as vertical shading angle. Yes, so vertical shading angle because we are trying to consider this as horizontal projection.
Okay,
horizontal projection, it can be, let's say, a roof slab, a building block itself. It can be any kind of support, it can be pergolas, it can be any member, any structural, or it can be a fixed member, or it can be movable also. So I can have the louvers in which I can adjust also.
Okay.
So it can be made up of stone, it can be made of any material. Basically, it gets the name of vertical horizontal shadow angle, horizontal shading device, because of its function. It functions as a shading device.
Okay.
So it can be something, let's say, umbrella also, which is you are keeping it for a temporary basis.
Okay.
Even then it is considered, it might be either temporary, it might be either permanent, it can be made up of any material.
Okay.
So we call it as a horizontal shading device. Okay, similarly we call vertical shading devices. Similarly this we call it as horizontal shading device.
Okay.
So this is, I'll write it as outside. Yes, this is outside and this is inside. Yes. So this is my basic wall, which is brick wall. Let's see. This is wall, brick wall. Okay. So this is brick wall. So what I'm going to take is I'm going to take sunlight. Yes. So this is very much clear. So this is. So this is a horizontal along the horizon. This is a horizontal line. So we have two angles and angles. Yes. So this is nothing but summer, winter sun, and this is summer sun. Okay. So based on your altitude, can you please tell me what is the vertical shading angle for summer sun and winter sun?
Okay.
These two angles, what is, yes, for summer sun and for winter sun. Yes, there are two angles that are created. So please find out based on the latitude and distance, what is the shading angle. Yes, what is the shading angle? You know what is altitude angle for summer solstice and winter solstice. So for that we need to understand what is the shading angle. So for this I think we need to understand first what is. We need to have three values.
Yes,
we need to have three values. So first we need to understand what is the height of opening. Yes, I'll call it as O, height of opening. Yes. Okay. And the depth of projection. Okay. So I will consider what is the depth of projection. I'm considering from the inner side to the exterior most. Okay, because of this triangle, what I'm taking here. Okay. So this depth we consider it as, let's say, 600 mm, and this height of the opening I consider it as 100 mm. So can you find out
what is the angle?
You already know that tan theta, this tan theta is equal to opening divided by the projection. Now you know size of the opening by projection.
So basically this exercise can also be done other ways where I can, I'm not giving the opening or the things. So based on the whatever the shading angle you are getting, you can calculate either this, you can keep this as fixed. Yes, you can keep this thing as 1200 and you can calculate how much should be the projection. Yes, if you know the angle. Yes, if you know the angle, then I can calculate what should be the projection. Yes, based on this. Yes, if I don't know the things, I think better to go with this exercise because you already know what is the altitude angle. Yes, you know the altitude angle for summer sun and you know the altitude angle for winter sun. So basically you are going to take this. I think better you first do the sketch and then you try to resolve it. Yes, so here we need to understand what is this angle and what is this angle. So for that, you can understand this is what is this angle, what is this angle. Okay. Similarly, now only you have to do is calculate what is a projection. I think this is not required. Summer sun is not required. Only if you try to cut down the winter sun. Okay. Based on location again. If let's say if it is a very cold climate, then we need to consider the summer sun. We need not consider the winter sun. Okay. We are trying to harvest more sunlight. So that is why we consider summer sun or we don't give projections at all. Okay. So this you can consider this for the south facade. Yes, this you can consider for the south facade. You can assume that this is for the south facade, south wall facing the south side. Okay. So now what we are doing here is, so here we know what is this altitude angle. Yes. So this, now I am having my building here. Yes. So this is same as this. Yes. So I am having my building here. Now I want to know how much is this. We need to find out how much is this. I know the height of the opening is 1200 mm. Okay. I know this angle. It means I know this angle also.
Okay.
So this angle is same as this angle.
Yes?
Yes, sir.
Horizontal shading defects. Yes?
So this is nothing but again, this is called as vertical shading angle. I want to allow winter sun to enter into my building. Yes? But I don't want anything after above that to come into my building because anything above that will be considered as during hot days. Okay. So this based on my thing, so sun will be after some time. And then maximum reaches here, and after that again it goes back. Okay, for summer and during winter it keeps, yes, like this. Yes, so that we start with sun path. I think you can also check in sun path. So during winter it will be on the lower altitude, and during summer it will be in higher altitude. Okay, again, yes. So because of the earth rotation and all those things that we are studying. So I want to allow this sunlight to come inside my building. Yes. So that is why I will try to give my projection till here only. Okay. So that I can allow maximum sunlight to come inside. Yes. So now you need to calculate how much is this. Yes. So that you can also cut the summer sun. Yes.
Okay.
So this thing is very simple. Okay. So you already know the angle for your location. Yes. So based on that, you are going to calculate what should be the length of projection. Okay. You can consider this as for south. I said because of south, because if you are, let's say, your building sunlight is in this direction. Yes. If you are, so it is slightly tilted towards because let's say if you are considering sun path, then your building, let's say the sun rises slightly towards south and this thing. So I am trying to calculate the winter sun
So that is winter sun. So whatever the equation that 90 degree plus 23, it is for the highest altitude that it reaches from summer or during winter. Yes, the highest altitude that the sun reaches during summer or winter, and the highest altitude is during the afternoon. Okay, so that is why we can get what is the angle, that is what is the sunlight that we want to penetrate inside during the winters. Yes. So this is basically this is the same calculation for throughout the world for all the tropical climates, because only tropical climates, or I can say along the equator, all the countries that are falling into the range, that is let's say from Tropic of Cancer to Tropic of Capricorn. Okay, so all the buildings that are falling into this belt needs lot of sunlight that is during or basically hot. Okay, or you can say tropical climates. Yes, so that is why they don't want summer sun, they want winter sun. So you can say, you can also say that most of the buildings on the planet Earth require winter sun but not summer sun, based on this. Okay, but supposedly if you are designing something in Antarctica or polar climates, or let's say Canada, some climates like the northern Canada and this thing, so then you need to harness lot of summer sun. And also let's say if you get a project in let's say Ooty or Kodaikanal, or let's say Madikeri. Okay, so even Madikeri is now again, because of global warming, we can see the slight temperature variation. There is some temperature difference. Okay, but let's say in India also, if you are doing, if it is in India also, near Mahabaleshwar, or let's say near Mount Abu. Okay, so there if you are doing projects, yes, so then you need to harvest summer sun also, because they are mainly cold climates. Yes, they are cold regions. Yes, the cold region is because of the altitude. Yes, because of the altitude, that is they are slightly higher than the mean sea level. Okay, or very higher than mean sea level, so that is why they are very cold climate. Best example is Ooty, where you need to harvest lot of sunlight. Yes, so that is why we need to use the summer sun also. Okay, so there we can't say we are going to cut the winter sun, but the challenge you get in Ooty is there is lot of rainfall. Yes, so you need to design the devices, so that is why they try to use the, if you see the buildings in Ooty, they try to use this. Yes, and they might give some openings here so that they can harvest some sunlight. Yes, they can harvest lot of light. And they don't give too much of projection, they'll give little projection so that water is not dripping along the walls. So dripping along the walls, so that is why they give this projection, so that it goes away from the building. Yes, so they don't give so much more projection, because if they are giving more projection, then this portion will get shaded, and if that portion gets shaded, then again it is creating cold. So they want to increase the heat gain. Yes, they want more building to absorb more heat, so that is why they stay in a very thermally comfortable environment. Okay, so I hope this is done. So next question is, so basically it has very similar questions. So next question is also very similar. So it is only to design what is, you can say, vertical shading device. The vertical shading devices can be in the form of a fin. Yes, it can be a fin, and it can be fixed, it can be adjustable. Okay, but we can't say that because it is adjustable we don't have to calculate angles. Okay, so sometimes what happens, even in plan also, we need the buildings to be arranged. Let's say one block is like this, another building block is like this. We are giving, let's say, some kind of courtyards in between. So for that, we need to understand what is, let's say, now sun rises here, okay, and it sets here. Okay. So in this case, what happens if, let's say, this is building block. Yes. If this is building block. If this is building block. And this is building block. And I'm giving courtyard in this direction. Let's say this is southwest. Yes. If I'm giving building blocks in the southwest direction, then it means I'm allowing lot of sunlight here. Yes, I'm getting sunlight this afternoon. Let's say this is this timing, you can say till 7 p.m. Starting from, let's say 2 p.m.
Okay, so 2 p.m. 1 or 1 p.m. we can consider here. So it is slightly angled from 2 p.m. to 7 p.m. This whole portion is getting heated up. Okay, but here we can see that there is some portion which is shaded. This portion is shaded. This portion is shaded. Yes. So for this shaded portion, the building block itself acts as vertical shading device. Now, is there any way by the same buildings I can arrange in such a way that this courtyard, which is having more activities, can be shaded for a longer period? Yes, or it can have better shaded areas. So that is why what I'll do, I'll take these three and I'll try to rearrange these blocks in such a way that the courtyard space is getting lot of shaded area. Yes. So here it is not getting any shade. So what happens? I'll try to take the three blocks itself. Yes. So what I'll do? I'll take this. Yes. The same three blocks. Let's say I'll not be exactly this thing. Okay. So I'll try to take these three blocks. I'll try to rearrange with little bit change. And now what happens? Sun rises. Yes. And it is via south. It will set in the. Now here what I'm having, the sunlight, let's say it is, yes, from all the directions, at all the timelines, starting from morning, yes, morning, let's say morning here, yes, the sunlight is hitting, yes, there is some penetration, some reflection, because of some reflection I'm getting, so this what happens, it gets diffused, yes, the light when it touches, any edge, we already studied that it gets diffused. Yes? So let's say this is the edge of a building. If this is, let's say, edge of a building block. So then sunlight, it gets diffused. And diffused light will not have a lot of heat. Yes? It is a very diffused. Either we can use a lot of reflected light or we can have diffused light. North light is supposed to be very good light because it is all reflected light. Now, north light, whatever the from the north direction, whatever light we are getting is all because of some reflection that is happening somewhere. So it is only reflected light. So it is very ambient. It is very good for your activities like, let's say, reading or any other activity. So it does not carry heat. This is only for the tropical climates. Yes? And it is not carrying a lot of heat. Okay. So now what happens? So this whole portion is getting shaded. Yes, because of sunlight. This portion is getting shaded. So I can see that I have increased the shaded space. Yes. Just by arrangement of different blocks, what I'm doing is I'm trying to arrange and to make I'm getting lot of shaded area. Okay. So here I'm not getting any shaded area. Here I'm getting lot of shaded areas. Yes. Just because of the rearrangement of the same blocks in such a manner. Okay. So now this kind of massing, this is kind of massing you can also try to do with design also, your work out with your design also. So let's say there are a lot of outdoor activities, yes, even if you can see our courtyard is also, most of the time it is shaded, okay. And there is a tree which is giving, again, further shading that particular courtyard also, okay. So this is the kind of arrangement that we can do to achieve maximum mutual shading or this thing. So these are also acting as vertical shading device. Yes, these building blocks are actually acting as vertical shading device. Yes, we also studied what how it acts as a horizontal shading device. Similarly, these building blocks are also acting as vertical shading device. Yes, so we need to know what is the relation between these two this thing so that we can design another block which will block the sunlight and it will give more shaded spaces. Yes. So this is the last exercise for today. So basically what you are doing, so this I am doing in plan. Okay, let's say this is I am doing in plan. Okay. So what you have to do, so let's consider this is a south side facade. Yes. This is south. Yes. This is, let's say, east. And this is, let's say, west. Okay. So basically what I am doing is I am trying to find out a shading device for my wall. Okay. So let's say this is a wall.
Yes. Now, especially, I don't want the sunlight to enter into my building, that is during summer or during, especially during afternoons. Yes. So that is why I need to understand what is first thing is what is azimuth angle for this. Yes. Azimuth angle is nothing but horizontal angle. Let's say if it is north, south, okay, east and west. So whatever angle I am creating, let's say this building block is like this. Yes. So whatever this angle is nothing but it is azimuth angle. Okay. So this angle, the horizontal angle. Let's say if sun is here, sun rising here. So this angle is nothing but you can say azimuth angle. Okay. From the north, how much it is towards the towards east or towards south, whatever. Okay. So I can use sometimes give azimuth angle based on whatever the closest this thing. From the east, you can say the azimuth angle is so much. Okay. So this azimuth angle also you are getting based on that app that you have installed. Yes. In the previous class. Okay. So based on that, I can avoid sunlight for different timings. Yes. So now what you have to do is you need to design or you need to find out what is the projection, that is vertical shading angle, vertical shading device, vertical shading device. Yes. Yes. For this we need to understand azimuth angle, that is nothing but horizontal shading angle. Yes. So based on the horizontal shading angle, yes, we can consider how much is this. Yes. Let's say for a particular time period. Okay. So this is brick wall. I don't want any sunlight, let's say after from 2 p.m. till 2 p.m. it's okay for me. So after 2 p.m. to, let's say 2 p.m. to 7 p.m. I don't want any light entering into my building, okay, or in this building. So what I do is I'll try to design the shading device in such a way that let's say whatever I am doing this thing. So we'll consider the size of opening as let's say 900 mm. The size of opening is nothing but 900 mm. Yes, it is very close to 1 meter. That is size of the window. Okay. Here we don't consider the height, but we consider what is a vertical shading device. So for that we know what is the azimuth angle for 2 p.m. and 7 p.m. for that particular location. Yes, you can know, you can consider it for summer. Okay, for the summer solstice, what is the angle for 2 p.m. to 7 p.m. Yes, or you can consider for equinox also. You can consider for winter solstice also. Okay. So, what is the sunlight that is I am getting from 2 p.m. to 7 p.m. Yes, if I don't want this sunlight only for summers, then you can consider only for the summer solstice. Yes, for summer solstice, what is the angle? Okay, or you can consider what is the winter solstice. Okay, so winter solstice means it is not the altitude angle, it is the azimuth angle. Okay, so it is you can consider for winter solstice because the sun is at little lower altitude, but again there is lot of light that is entering into the building. Okay, so for this let's say I'm trying to do this in blue, so this vertical shading device. Yes. So I need to find out how much is this. Okay. So how much is the vertical shading angle? Okay. Sorry, vertical shading. So this is the question. Okay. Now based on 2 p.m. to 5 p.m. or you can consider any one. You can consider 2 p.m. Okay. You don't have to consider 7 p.m. If you are cutting sun at 2 p.m., obviously you are cutting sun at 7 p.m. also because it is south and sun moves from south. Okay, you need to understand what is this, the sun at, let's say, 2 p.m. Okay, so this is, let's say, sun is in this location at 2 p.m. Okay, so you can consider for 2 p.m., don't consider for 7 p.m. So sun is here at 2 p.m. Okay, now the sunlight that goes here, so I'm going to block. Yes. So this very little, or you can consider it as blocking. Okay. So I need to understand, yes, how much is this, because I know whatever the azimuth angle. Yes. You can say I know this angle. Yes. So this you can consider it as solar azimuth. This is also, you can also call it as horizontal. Yes, horizontal shadow angle for 2 pm and change it to calculate what is the vertical shading angle. Okay, so this is also based on the same equation. Yes, tan theta is equal to opening by the projection. Same, okay. Only you need to understand what you need to find out theta by azimuth angle at that particular time. Okay, this is your building. Yes, which is facing towards, let's say it is facing towards, this is facing towards this north, south, this and east, okay, and west. Okay. Now sun rises in east somewhere, yes, somewhere rises in east, and it takes this path and it sets in west somewhere. Okay. So it reaches, it starts rising at, let's say, 6:43 or 6:45 a.m. based on different timeline, based on different time location and this thing. So it starts rising and it reaches the maximum zenith at, let's say, it reaches its zenith around 1 pm. Okay. So 2 pm onwards, it starts setting from the, it starts coming down from the horizon again towards the west. Yes. So when it reaches, let's say, around 2 pm, so then there is some kind of light that is being light that is being entering into this building block. Yes. So light is entering in this building block because of this certain openings. Yes. So I want to design a shading device which will block the sunlight from 2 pm onwards. Yes. So how do I do that? I have given actually the solution also. So based on whatever the azimuth angle at particularly, let's say, 2 pm. So I know what is this angle of incidence of sunlight. So I know what is the angle of incidence of sunlight at 2 pm. Okay. Now all I have to do is I have to block whatever the sunlight is coming after 2 pm. To do that, I need a vertical shading device. Yes. So sunlight is coming from this side, it is coming from this side. I can further extend more or I can make it very small. Yes. So this will block the sunlight. So that is the question regarding horizontal shading device. Okay. So for this, again you can calculate same way what was what you did with shading device. Yes. Tan theta is equal to size of opening by projection. So what happens if I want to block at sunlight at 1 pm? Okay. So then I need to use a combination of both, that is horizontal shading device and vertical shading devices, that becomes accurate. Okay. So I'll just give a brief of accurate devices and calculation in next class. Okay. For this class, we'll only deal with vertical shading devices and horizontal shading devices. Yes. So this is also to understand that, let's say, if I'll draw this in, let's say, if my, let's say, vertical shading device, supposedly, assume. Okay. So this is not regarding this, this thing. So supposedly, if it becomes very big, then I can do my building something like this. So next block, I can do like this. Yes. So because of which, what happens? I'm going to shade this complete area, the complete facade, the complete elevation is getting shaded. Yes. So this dotted I'm showing because it is an imaginary block, imaginary line. Yes. So this line, let's say this is all imaginary line. Yes. This is all imaginary. This is a block which is imaginary. So instead of designing the vertical fin, what I will do is I will design a block which is like this, which is shading this entire facade. So then I can give little more bigger also. So let's say now if I am getting this much of shaded area, then what I'll do is I'll try to give the big window, because anyways it is shaded and I'm getting some nice view of this area or something like that. Okay. So basically for that we need to understand what should be the minimum size, minimum projection, minimum vertical fin, that is projection from the wall, so that I can cut this length. Okay. Okay, some of the building designs itself, the elevation or facade is based on these kind of arrangements. Yes, they try to make brick. You must have seen many projects, so you don't know. Sometimes you think the particular form is unintentional or they try to play with the form. You can actually develop the form based on the shading, vertical shading or horizontal shading angles. Yes, so that is adding more to the functionality of the particular building, not just being aesthetic. If you want to take certain, let's say, solid and void, you want to play with the massing or forms. So you can consider these. So once you know this, so then you can start playing. So you need, there is a need that is generated. So now you know that we need a shading device in this direction. Yes. So that is why what I do is I try to create some kind of massing or you know building forms or kind of shading devices for that particular shading. Or sometimes I will say I will plant trees here. I will not plant trees here because here I want more sunlight. I want sunlight till 2 p.m. That is why I don't want to plant trees here. So I will plant trees here because this sunlight is bad. Okay.